All right. Hello and welcome back. It is Gauntlet of Greatness time. We're looking at the modern bracket. It is time for a second match. Here you get a look at all 24 decks that are competing to see what's the best deck in modern right now. The portion of the bracket we're going to be playing in is the Arabian Nights edition. The Arabian Nights region, headlined by the Splinter Twin deck, which is one basically half of the modern Pro Tours that have ever happened. It's 2-for-4 at this stage. The match we're going to be playing, though, is Jund against Tron. The vote-in match was Mono Blue Tron versus Red Green Tron. I actually thought Mono Blue Tron did a little better at the most recent Pro Tour, but Red Green Tron is what the people demanded, so Red Green Tron it is. And that's the deck that we're going to be watching against Jund this time around. So here you get a look at the Urzatron deck. It's Tron because your goal is to assemble Urza's Tower, Urza's Power Plant, and Urza's Mine. For 20 years now, people have referred to that as assembling the Urzatron. If you do it, your three lands tap for 7 mana, exactly the right amount for playing Karn Liberated. Or, you know what, we'll pay 7 for Wurmcall Engine and still feel pretty good about that. Oblivion Stone can mop up whatever the opponent is up to. Pyroclasm can sweep away their weenies. The rest of the deck is basically just ways to go get the Tron, right? You've got some color-fixing cantrips with the Sphere and the Star. You've got Expedition Map, which can go get any land. You've got Ancient Stirrings, which can either go get a land, or if you've got the lands, and sometimes you're just fishing for one of those colorless threats, like the Wurmcoil Engine or the Karn. So Eye of Ugin's a fun one of. You got an Emrakul that sometimes you can actually just cast. Sideboard's got an Ugin hanging out in it. Sylvan Scrying pieces things together. So pretty fun deck. Certainly fuels the sort of little kid Timmy that's inside all of us. The opponent this time around is Jund. So not Abzan, but Jund. Black-green X decks have been around as long as Modern Constructed has been around. Tarmogoyf, Liliana, you know, Abrupt Decay, Maelstrom Pulse. These decks have been very good. Thoughtseize, of course, Inquisition of Kozilek. That shell has gone into a lot of Modern decks. And nowadays, it seems like most people go for Abzan. And in fact, Abzan is the number 2 overall seed in this entire bracket. But there's still some reasons where you might consider playing Jund, or you might take your black-green deck and say, yeah, you know what, I'm going to splash red instead of white. I don't get Lingering Souls, but what I do get is the ability to blow up everybody else's spirit tokens. So that's kind of cool. And you know what, I get the ability to kill creatures, no questions asked, with Terminate. I get Hunt Masters. I get Lightning Bolt. Lightning Bolt's just really, really good at what it does. And because the deck's a little lower on the mana curve, you can run 4-dot Confidants without worrying too much. Of course, new edition Tossiger is still kind of fun for the deck. It's a Reduke list. It's got, you know, man lands, just basically everything you need to go into the attrition matchup. And that is what Shadow is going to be playing this. So my opponent for the Gauntlet continues to be Shadow Detella, former Pro Tour player, guy that I ran into back when I was playing on the Pro Tour, and continue to play lots of board games with. So he's definitely part of the East Coast board game circuit, board game tournaments that I fly out to all the time. Now then, the red-green Tron deck. Tower, Player, Plant, Mine, that looks like a keeper. Can't cast this. Can't do anything with my mana, but keep. Come on, top deck. Oh, yeah, let's... No longer a practice match. Real match this time. To see for the top 16. I should play the redundant one. Yeah, I guess I'm going to hold on to this so that I can Pyroclasm away any Dark Confidants. Sweet. Wow, deck's going great. Just the way we drew it up, right? Now, all we need is a Wurmcoil or a Karn off the top. Yeah, I mean, he gets my Oblivion Stone. I'm not in love with that. But it means he gets to see that whatever is about to happen to him will have been off the top. Yeah, 2/2 Pyroclasm, your Dark Confidant. Just the way this deck drew it up. I feel like we can lose the Oblivion Stone there. Ooh, Scavenging. All right. Come on, deck. Top of the deck says Grove of the Burn Willows. That's no fun. Now, do I pop the Chromatic Star? If I hit, I think I do. It's mildly awkward if I hit a, if I hit Karn, it's vulnerable to Thoughtseize, but if I hit Worm Coil, it's insane. So I'm going to pop it. Sylvan's Crying. So, okay. We go get Iaugin. And next turn. This deck's insane. My position, I have 3 lands in play and 5 lands in my hand, and I'm happy. 8 lands, nothing but 8 lands. Who needs more than lands? Tempo's not great here. He's got multiple guys, and it's going to take me a turn to go get a Worm Coil. So, I mean, we don't have the game won by any stretch of the imagination. Losing that, that helps. Do I play Iaugin? No, I just play another tower, right? No reason to play the I. Yet. That helps. Great. Okay, now I feel better. Now I can take a turn off to get Worm Coil, but I have a Worm Coil. Man, I just start attacking with it, right? What's he gonna do? I mean, he can't really race. Kind of has to block it. Yeah, I mean, I could have played the eye there, but I'm like, this gives me more mana to do stuff with. I don't think it's gonna matter. Oh, Thunder Maw. Okay, that's not nothing. That guy has flying, so basically I need a Karn or an O-Stone. I can no longer race with one Worm Coil. I wonder if I can race with two. Living right. Doing something right. Oh, I should have attacked without giving him this information. I just couldn't resist. Yeah, I have to kill the Thunder Maw. He can kill the Karn with a suicide attack. If I attack into him, then it's not a suicide attack. Four, yeah, I'll just play the eye. I know I'm going to spend a land drop on it eventually. So my question is, do I attack him? If I... I think I don't attack... Yeah, I think I'll just play defense. If he wants to kill Karn, it's going to cost him a creature. Or a lightning bolt. That part's sad. I kind of wish I'd attacked. Eh. Liana? Do I need this forest? No, I have Grove. Three, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12. So I cannot actually eye for a Worm Coil yet. I can play Grove for Ancient Stirrings for something cool, which I guess is better than playing a power plant. Because if I miss, I can still eye for a Worm Coil to play next turn. Nothing cool. It's too bad. Is Chromatic Sphere better or Urza's Tower? Feel like Urza's Tower might actually be better. Nah. Card off the top. Right. Oh, green here, right? Or red do anything? Red doesn't do anything. Wound up with the tower anyway. Hilarious. All right, am I attacking? I think I'm attacking. Yeah, tower to Emrakul either way, right? Oh, I can get Emrakul. The tower either, I have the Emrakul either way. 3, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay, I needed exactly tower for Emrakul. Fine. We're gonna get Emrakul next turn. We may as well play defense. Make sure nothing crazy happens, right? Sure. Emrakul's pretty fun. No problem. This really is an Emrakul game, isn't it? You see the one eye Mugen in these deck lists. You see the one Emrakul. It's never gonna come up. Actually, it comes up. Pretty much right here. Awesome. 3, 6, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Oh, what am I doing? Oh God, no! Sorry, guys. Knee-jerk tapped my land in Magical Online, assumed I was activating Eye of Ugin. Yeah, this doesn't actually tap for mana for Eldrazi spells. It just makes the Eldrazi spells cost less, which also means any land would have been good enough for Emrakul. But what's not good enough for Emrakul is accidentally activating Eye of Ugin when you have mana floating in your mana pool. My bad. Next turn. Stupid. Oh, he had enough for the. I forgot he could scavenging was my guy. That was a dumb attack. Mostly tilting from the Emrakul. Yeah, not the greatest attack. I didn't realize he could get that guy to 4/4. Thoughtseize and eat Emrakul with scavenging ooze would be super sad here. I mean, we'll still probably win with the two Wurmcoil engines. But that would be sad. Does he kill the Death Touch one? Yeah. Looks like we get our Ember Cool play anyway. Probably should break myself of the habit of tapping my mana first. It used to be that was the only way you were allowed to play Magic. Back in the day, you had to play your mana first. Then they changed it, and I never quite picked up the habit. But we get there anyway. All right. Tell you what, we'll play a mine. I'll tap Emrakul. 6, 9, 1, 2, 3. I'll tap too much because I still can't get Eye of Ugin right, because I've never actually played this deck before. But it won't matter because we have Emrakul. And now we have an extra turn. Do I just attack with the lifelink guy? There's no reason not to, right? Sure. Yay! Yeah, no permanence for you. Goodbye, your things. Oh, he came to life. Ha! He's actually not dead yet. Forgot he gained a life from Snapcaster. Maybe it's not over yet. Pretty sure it's over. Sure, the Huntmaster. Keep that one. All right, so there's going to be another turn. I'm going to have a blocker for it. Yeah, I think we got that one. Cool. Yeah, drawing Urza Tron seems good. All right. How do I sideboard? I think Ugin and All His Dust is worth it. I definitely like the Crucible. I kind of like the Relic. These combusts should be Rending Volleys. I just haven't updated my deck list for dragons. But what's bad against him, right? If these Pyroclasms, I guess they're only okay. They kill what? Just the Confidant? Spellskite's not good in this matchup. That makes sense. What else am I cutting, though? I gotta cut two cards. I don't know if four Pyroclasms is right. I mean, maybe it's just important to kill Dark Confidant, but I don't like having four answers for three threats. Might kill an ooze. That's really not happening. It kills a Huntmaster. I think I like cutting one Pyroclasm. And I don't know if I want all the relics. Like, going to two relics feels decent. But I mean, I still have to cut a card. What am I cutting? I'm not cutting the Emrakul. That was too good. Need another cut. Karn is not awesome here, right? He just keeps killing them. Maybe I cut one Karn. I have the Ugin instead. That feels pretty good. Yeah. All right. Let's do it. The vote index are doing pretty well. You guys voted in the Loam Pox deck, which just showed Scapeshift both sides of its hand. And you guys voted in the Tron deck. Well, I mean, there was going to be a Tron deck either way. It was just a question of which one. Never cut Karn. Never cut Karn. I have Ugin. Dies. Yeah. I mean, Karn was decent. Maybe he kills. Ah, whatever. We have a deck. We have a deck that has zero pieces of the Tron. Which means we have a mulligan. Yeah. We have Karn with no Tron, with a Sylvan Scrying. I think that's still a mulligan. What does that hand do? That's to blow up an Oblivion Stone. Yeah, it's got a 5 and a 7, and it's just, it's not even close. Wow. That hand's even worse. Do I go to 4? Ugh. I mean, the 6 was better than this 5, but I don't know. I think maybe we go to 4. Yeah. Can't keep that. Good grief! Wow, we've yet to... It's like I feel like I'm mulliganing to Bazaar of Baghdad in Vintage, but I have 12 Bazaars in my deck, and I'm still somehow over. This is insane. I've literally not seen a single piece of the Urzatron. Running it. We got this. No problem. Crazy. Not my fault. If he's going to duress me, I'd rather lose the relic. Yeah, I'd rather lose the relic. Not that it's a duress, right? It's an Inquisition or it's a Thoughtseize, but still. Oh, Ancient Grudge. Flame. Okay. No. Take that, Ancient Grudge. Can't even kill a relic. What good are you? I mean, look, the top of my deck, the top of our deck could help, right? Well, Pyroclasm would help a lot. I'd settle for an Urza piece. Hilarious. Still in it, right? I mean, the things that deck is capable of are absurd enough that... Oh, bye-bye, Crucible. We knew you when. He discards an extra Liliana. No reason to give him any decisions. I did not know Shatterstorm was going to come in this matchup, but you know what? It's pretty good here. Funny. He did not plus Liliana. What do I do? Ancient Stirrings while I still have a forest in my hand? So that I can find and play a Tron piece. And then I miss. Blah. I can't keep the Sylvan Scrying through Liliana. So I take Chromatic Sphere and then just have no cards in my hand. I think that's how I have to play it. Sure, Confidant, no problem. And a Tarmogoyf, I see how it is. Come on, top of the deck. I don't even know what I need. I need runners. He discards the Thoughtseize, because when am I going to have cards in my hand, right? Mine. So I could pop Chromatic Sphere, but I don't think I want to. I think next turn we pop Chromatic Sphere for something dramatic. Yeah, that's the plan. Next turn, we're going to draw Urza's Tower and Wyrmcoil Engine. That's the plan. Oh, what did he get from Bob? Thoughtseize. I've got like a turn to pull this off. No problem. Hey, pretty good for a mulligan to three, right? Oh, power plant. Oh, so close. I have to pop this. I don't think it matters. Wow. That's cool. Maybe we have a turn left. Why couldn't you be a Wyrmcoil Engine? Or an Ugin? Why can't... Oh, how good if this power plant was an Ugin? Come all the way back. I think I still have a turn to top deck Ugin. He draws Terminate. He hits me for what, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7? Can he activate that? Even if he can, it's not dealing 13. Yeah, he got my power plant. His Terminate, Tarmogoyf's 4, 5. Come on, Ugin off the top. Seven, yeah. We're dead next turn. We get one draw phase. Chromatic Star. Okay. Maybe we get more than one draw phase. Oh my god, Karn. Do you do anything? 3, 6, 7. You must do something, right? Oh, it's not good enough, is it? Yeah, I can exile Tarmogoyf, and I still die to Treetop plus Dark Confidant. Ah, well. We're just going to keep killing Tarmogoyf. Maybe he can't count to 4, and he'll attack Karn. Close. Oh, the Ugin top deck loses to Wyrmcoil, doesn't it? Funny. Man, imagine if we'd started with 7 cards that game instead of 3. That game would have been great. Yep. It's just Raging Ravine. Probably should have drawn 7 cards. Yes, yes, no. Okay, has anything changed on sideboarding? We're on the play now. Relic seemed good. All his dust seemed like... Oh, all his dust would have been a decent top deck. Still died of the lands, but... Karn is the one... I could put the 4th Karn in, but what would I... What do I take out for a 4th Karn? And it feels like the matchup... Karn isn't great in the matchup. It's fine. I mean, it's a thing. Take out the Emrakul because Wyrmcoils is good enough. That's actually a lot to be said for that. This is not a matchup where I require Emrakul to win. If I'm ever at the point where I have Eye of Ugin going, the 4 Wyrmcoils is going to get it done. And if I have Emrakul in my hand and I'm like Tron with no threat, all right, I'll buy that. Got it. Come on, game 3. Sweet 16, spot on the line. We can go look at the bracket. The winner of this will be taking on Splinter Twin, which is Tron's trying to get to the top 16 while it can. That's not a great matchup for Splinter Twin, but what are you going to do? God, I bet the Splinter Twin deck is super cheering for Tron here, right? Jund is a major problem, but Tron is totally beatable. But hey, that's for a couple of weeks from now. For now, we got to see if Tron or Jund can get it done. Game 3. Oh, I keep forgetting to update these. Tron is on 1. Jund also on 1. Tower, mine, map, and our good friend Karn Liberated. I think we're going to keep this draw. But I mean, he's got all kinds of ways to cause all kinds of problems. Like, for example, Thoughtseize. Sad. He should take the Karn, right? He can't prevent me from assembling Tron with a Thoughtseize because next turn I have the map. Yeah, so he takes the Karn. Makes sense. Ooh, cool. I'm definitely going to leave the map in play rather than put a relevant card in my hand. It doesn't actually matter. Oh, Stunts is pretty good against him. Yeah, I mean, when we have Tron, this matchup seems great. When we mulligan to 3 and or fail to assemble Tron, matchup seems hard. Definitely one of the fun things with this whole gauntlet is just kind of seeing all the decks and how they work. Sure, you can have a Tarmogoyf. I have Tower Mine. I need Power Plant. Power Plant, Power Plant. Ha! Which is better? I Karn the Tarmogoyf? Make him show me a Lightning Bolt? And then play Worm Coil? Uses my mana better. What is Worm Coil? I mean, Worm Coil Engine blocks. But, yeah, I feel like I don't know which of these is better. I mean, it's an embarrassment of riches, obviously. These are high-class problems to have. Karn up? Karn up doesn't do anything, right? I get a card and then lose the 4 loyalty back. Karn plus? Sure. That's Karn plus. Yeah, I like Karn plus. Okay, Kitchen Finks. Yeah, Karn minus would kill the Tarmogoyf, but would die to a Lightning Bolt, which would be sad. I hope I don't lose this Worm Coil to a Thoughtseize here. That would also make me sad. It's already gone through one Thoughtseize, though, and it can't Inquisition it. Can't Liliana it. I mean, I obviously have lots of other things to discard. Another Tarmogoyf, sure. Yeah, he's going to protect Karn. That makes sense. Cool. So now we drop Worm Coil. But I just keep ticking Karn up, right? I mean, if he wants to send 2 Tarmogoyfs at Karn, one of them gets eaten by the Worm Coil. Even if he has a removal spell for the Worm Coil, the 2 parts can double block a Tarmogoyf. Yeah, I think we keep going up. How does it feel, Jundek? How does it feel to have your hand attacked? Ooh, Ancient Grudge. Happy that's not around. Pretty good. Attacking? Sure. Oh, no, you need to double block if you split it. I only have to block with the Death Touch one. Oh, it's got another Ancient Grudge. Sure. So he'll get to keep two Tarmogoyfs out of this. Which is not nothing. Oh, he also sends an artifact and an instant to the yard. So Tarmogoyfs are 6/7 now. That's less than ideal. Interesting. I cannot Oblivion Stone and pop it. He's got two cards in his yard. I can go up and keep attacking his hand. I can... Oh, Ancient Grudge. Where's his green mana? He's got one source of green mana. Hypothetically, I could destroy the Stomping Ground, because my Death Touch Worm token is going to die to this Ancient Grudge. Interesting. Wow. I mean, I feel like I'm crushing, but I also feel like there's these 2/6/7 Tarmogoyfs, and I can only kill one of them. I can O Stone. I can play the Oblivion Stone. Oh, I can Sylvan Scrying for a land. Right. So if I get... I play 2-mana Chromatic Star. I can tap Tower to Chromatic Star for Sylvan Scrying for Eye of Ugin. And then I have my never-ending supply of Worm Coils set up. So that's pretty good. I can also put an O-Stone on the table, which is pretty good. Right. So I get the Eye. I guess let's see what happens there, because maybe it changes some of my decisions. Star for green mana. I can see another Sylvan Scrying, which I can't cast, but that's okay. So I get the Eye. Great. That will be the land drop for the turn. So now I have 4 mana. I'm going to be playing an Oblivion Stone. The question is just, what do I do with Karn? I can kill a Tarmogoyf, or I can kill a Stomping Grounds, or I can go plus, get a card from his hand. He's going to grudge the Death Touch token and attack me with 2 Tarmogoyfs. That line doesn't sound great. I feel like it's either Stomping Grounds or plus. If I get the Stomping Grounds, then next turn I have nothing to do but plus. Also go to me in theory. I mean, something to be said, if I get the Stomping Grounds or a card from hand, then this O-Stone can mop up the Tarmogoyfs next turn. Right, I'm going to lose Karn. I mean, it's going to be really hard to keep Karn here. I don't know what the point is of killing a Tarmogoyf if I'm going to play O-Stone. Like, if I'm going to activate the Oblivion Stone, which I am, then I should attack a permanent that I can't just blow up with Oblivion Stone. Like the Stomping Grounds or a card from his hand. Interesting. I feel like there's value in killing his stomping grounds. And then next turn, I can blow up the world of Tarmogoyfs. I'm gonna attack his lands. Of course, he can flashback right now. I've done this whole line of thought thinking of the stomping grounds as tapped. Okay, I came to the worst possible conclusion. I don't think it's gonna matter, but that was not great. I was thinking I could keep the Death Touch guy for a turn to block a Tarmogoyf, but of course it's untapped. Sometimes you get too far down inside your own head and just lose track of things. I should have gotten a card from his hand, make him attack with both Tarmogoyfs. That's what I should have done. I mean, it's still good to get rid of his green mana. Like, I don't think this line is terrible because it turns off, yeah. He's got red black again. It turns off Abrupt Decay. It turns off Maelstrom Pulse. My Oblivion Stone is a lot more likely to survive this line. And it's just a question of, did I want the land from, oh, it's got Lightning Bolt, sure. Kills the lifelinker, fair enough. It's his Tarmogoyf goes to 6 power, so now presumably he's going to kill Karn and also deal 6 to me. Yeah, makes sense. We have more mana, which doesn't do a ton. So if that's 5 to blow, I can go ahead and get an Oblivion Stone into play. I guess that has value. 3, 5. I wasn't going to be able to activate the eye anyway. Okay, now I have 2, 4, 6, 9 mana. I can, in theory, get another tower, which is probably the play. So if I have 9, I cannot activate this and get a Worm Coil. Feels like I want to take a turn to acquire a Worm Coil engine. And I may as well Sylvan Scrying for another tower. Card is 4. It's useful to have for later. But for now, we'll get a Nurse's Tower. Yeah, I don't need Ghost Quarter, it's not like he has mana lands. So I could blow up to at least 0 cards in his hand. He has actual 0 cards in his hand. There's definitely value in just blowing up Dark Confidant and playing another Oblivion Stone. 3, 4, 5. Yeah, that works. The next turn I have 3, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. I have 12 mana, 13 mana. So yeah, I can activate, play Worm Coil anyway. Yeah, I'm gonna trade Oblivion Stone for Dark Confidant. Seems like Confidant's the only way he gets back in this game. I'm going to be annoyed if he comes up with land destruction for my mine, but these things happen. Zero cards in his hand. Oh, I guess if he came up with land destruction, he'd probably go for I. Another dark confidant. Hilarious. Alright, I'm not popping my last Oblivion Stone when I have the option of instead, right? 3, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Just pulling a worm coil. Dark Confidant gives him another Dark Confidant. Hilarious. Sure. Liliana, you want to split my worm coil? You can split my worm coil. You want my Chromatic Sphere from my hand? You can have my Chromatic Sphere from my hand. I get your Dark Confidant in that world. That's fine. I just attack him, right? Who cares about Liliana? Yeah, just attack him. Six, three, four, five, six, seven. The never-ending stream of worm coil engines is in fact going to get it done. Who needs Emrakul? Tassiger? That'd be hilarious. Swamp. I like her chances from here. Got there. Cool. Good game.
Good game, sir. I felt like my deck was completely outclassed there.
Yeah, well, if I get the Urzatron. I mean, we played the one game where I just didn't get an Urzatron in our practice game, and I felt outclassed, and I was like, oh, is this matchup just really hard? And they're like, no, the audience had me. They're like, no. The matchup's fine when you have Urzatron. You just play a never-ending stream of worm coil engines, and they fall over and die eventually.
Yeah.
And, you know, my mulligan to three hand, I also felt kind of outclassed, but I mean, it was only because it was a mulligan to three hand, right?
Sure. You mulligan to three and I'm like, all right, I have a chance.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah. All right. Well, good game, sir.
Yeah. No, your other chance is if you can come up with land destruction, right? You've got Fulminator Mages that could definitely mess me up.
Yep.
But I mean, when I have the Urzatron assembled, my cards just destroy yours.
Yeah, no, your cards are just better, but I mean, that's the whole deck, right?
Pretty much. Cool. Well, looks like that's going to do it for week one of season two of the Gauntlet of Greatness. So, Gauntlet of Greatness Modern Edition. We've been hanging out in the bracket. We've been hanging out in the Arabian Nights portion of the bracket. So far this week, we have seen the red-green Tron deck advance. We have seen the Loam Pox deck advance. So two wins for the vote-in favorites. Now the top eight, I gave the top eight decks a bye, and they got to get off the schneid now. Those decks are going to have to come to play. Splinter Twin and Jeskai Controller are going to have to play. But first, we'll go through the other three regions over the course of the next 3 weeks.